The climate crisis is threatening one of your favorite getaways and Instagram havens, Joshua Tree National Park. In the next century, all of this could disappear.
What a lot of people don't recognize is that the Joshua trees that are the namesake for the park are actually not doing well given the changing climatic condition. You know, the increasing temperatures, the decrease in rainfall and precipitation. There are going to be large parts of Joshua Tree that may no longer have a climate that's suitable for supporting those wonderful and magical Joshua Tree forests.
That's Bruce Stein, chief scientist at the National Wildlife Federation. I spoke to him to learn more about how climate change is destroying our national parks and what we can do to adapt. Because honestly, some things are already beyond saving when it comes to the climate crisis. As you saw in the intro, I got to visit Joshua Tree National Park in May and learned that many protected sites across the nation are actually in trouble. At this point, we're living in a world where organizations like the National Park Service and the National Wildlife Federation operate with a battlefield triage mindset, meaning they have to decide what to save and what is a lost cause.
What we're really talking about here is triage in terms of the natural world. But what I would say is that for me, the hardest to accept is when we're looking at the loss of entire species. I've spent most of my career focused on biodiversity conservation and documenting the risk of species extinction in plants and animals and working to prevent extinction because, you know, we actually have two crises underway right now. There's the climate crisis and there's the biodiversity crisis, which is illustrated by the increase in decline of species and populations and increase in the number of species that are becoming threatened and ultimately extinct. In fact, there's over 150 U.S. species that already have become extinct and another 450 or so that haven't been seen in so long, we have in this kind of missing in action category. Once those unique biological entities called species are gone, they're gone.
The National Park Service published an 80-page document this year that lays out frameworks and tools on how to cope with the uncertainty of future climate conditions. One of them is the RAD framework. No, really, that's the name. It stands for Resist, Accept, Direct. Its main objective is to help the National Park Service adjust to the increasingly rapid changes and try to reduce risks, whether it's drought, fires, or species extinction. Let's start with Resist, which basically looks into what we can still save.
The planning document that lays out this Resist, Accept, Direct framework, in essence, is describing, you know, what are the possible options? You know, when you're looking at a national park or individual features in a park, whether it's plants, animals, historic structures, cultural features, you know, asking ourselves which of them are most at risk from these changing climatic conditions, whether it's increasing temperature, erratic precipitation or extended drought, more severe wildfires, and asking which of these things are so important to us that we value so much that we're going to do whatever we can to resist those changes and try and ensure that they survive as they are.
Then we have accept, which is pretty straightforward. It's a way to embrace the grim reality that we reached the point where we're unable to protect everything we want to protect from the climate crisis.
But honestly, there are things that we simply are not going to be able to protect in those ways, and we have to acknowledge that. And so some of those changes we may not even have the ability to affect. And so that's where the accept comes in. Some of these changes we're just going to have to accept.
And finally, we have direct, which assesses risks and solutions on how to save remaining species and habitats.
And on the other hand, there are instances where we may, you know, acknowledge that these changes are happening, but we may have the ability to actually direct where that change goes so that it ends up in a better place than it might otherwise.
So to recap, resist what we can change, accept what we can't, and direct action to where it can have the most impact. When it comes to Joshua Tree National Park, scientists worry that future generations will find no actual Joshua trees at the park, which is not only ironic, but very sad. Wildfires are one of the main threats to parks like Joshua Tree. The Dome Fire, which took place during August 2020, took out approximately 1.3 million Joshua trees. Sure, you might say, let's just regrow them, but unfortunately, it's not that easy.
Now, the problem is that some species simply can't keep up with the velocity of change. That is, you know, if the climate is changing rapidly enough, you know, a lot of these things are not going to be able to naturally move on their own.
I know, this is grim. And like Bruce told me, it's like drinking from a fire hose of despair. But climate adaptation is fundamentally about hope. With the Biden-Harris administration, there has been a shift in focus when it comes to tackling climate change and biodiversity loss, which Bruce says it's a great first step. At the beginning of 2021, the Biden administration announced its commitment to conserving 30% of land and oceans by 2030. Although, there's still much more work to be done by not just governments, but also the corporate sector. And we're talking about things like continuing to reduce carbon emissions by setting net zero goals, keeping carbon sinks such as forests intact, investing in green solutions, and incorporating climate risks into planning and business processes.
We need to not think of climate change as something separate that's over here, but it's something that we need to integrate into our way of doing business and the planning and operations for everything that the agencies do, both state and federal, as well as at the local community level.
As for what you can do, well, just go outside and connect with nature. Learn its value and how to appreciate it.
So the next time you come to a place like Joshua Tree National Park, take some extra time to learn more about its status and ways you can help conserve it. And as they say, take only pictures and only leave footprints.